YOLO. So, you must have heard about blockchain maybe on YouTube, Instagram, or any news stories that you may find. But you know, blockchain kya hai? To understand what is blockchain, we need to understand why blockchain. So, I love to travel. And I know many of you like to travel as well. So, let's take an example from the travel field to understand why blockchain. One day, I decided that I will travel to Gopal for around 7 days. Among the other things that I need to plan for, I need to decide where I will stay. I googled it and I found a hostel in Gopal. I booked a bed for 2 nights in the hostel and boarded the train. On arrival, I came to know that this hostel has a capacity of 500 beds. So, this hostel is sufficiently big enough, and that's why they have costs such as cleaning, staff, electricity, etc. And the prices quoted by them are obviously determined after including these costs. Now, the hostel management, being the only central decision-making authority, increases the price on weekends and decreases them on weekdays. After checking, the hostel staff showed me my bed and also a common place where everyone in the hostel keeps their backpacks. They told me this place is relatively safe, but you need to take precautions and lock your backpack, and you are responsible for your backpacks or luggage's security. So here, I am just trusting this hostel management and its facilities for my stay and security. So after 2 nights, I decided to check out and visit a nearby village, of which so many people have told me about it. On arriving at this village, I came to know that they follow a community-based model. So you can stay at a homestay here, and as more and more travelers come in, more and more villages open their doors to these travelers, and that's why there is no fixed capacity limit as such. Moreover, these villages stay in their own home themselves, and whenever a traveler comes to stay with them, everyone in the village helps each other. Due to this, their cost is low and so is their prices. And as they are a community, they take every decision democratically by voting based on a consensus or majority. As in the homestay, I'm staying with the local family itself. I feel more secure here and I'm trusting the entire community. To summarize, hostel represents a traditional system and this community-based village model represents a blockchain system. Let's take a look at the differences. First, limit. In traditional system, the limit is fixed and it is difficult to increase the maximum capacity because of the cost and various other reasons. Whereas in the blockchain technology, there is no fixed limit. It can be increased as per the requirements by adding extra nodes and blocks. Second, price. The price in the traditional system is relatively high because of various costs involved in it. The price in the blockchain system can be comparatively low because of non-involvement of any middleman. Third, centralization. The traditional system is centralized and the authority to make decisions lies in the hands of one single party or organization. Whereas in blockchain technology, it is decentralized and the decisions are made based upon consensus or majority. Fourth, security. In traditional system, there are security concerns. In case of theft, all data is at risk. Whereas in blockchain, it is comparatively more secure mainly because of the consensus mechanism and the data being distributed across the network. Fifth, trust. In the traditional system, I have to trust only a single party or organization. Whereas in blockchain technology, I don't need to trust any single party or organization, but my trust is on the entire community or the network itself. So, these are the benefits of blockchain technology. We will learn more about this in further videos. Now, what is blockchain? At its core, blockchain is a distributed digital ledger or an online khata book that stores data or information of any kind. To understand, let's consider that you own a general store. In this general store, you will need to buy stock first and then sell it to your customers. Then there will be some debtors and some creditors. And to remember these and also to know your profit, you need to record these transactions somewhere, right? So this collection of accounts that you will record maybe in a book or a computer is called a ledger or khata book. Now, if this book gets lost or this computer gets damaged, and if you have not created any backup of it, you will lose all your data, right? So, this is where the power of blockchain technology comes in. In blockchain technology, many identical copies of this data is created and stored on multiple computers across the network. Even if a computer is down or destroyed, the data is safe and secured across this decentralized digital ledger network. Once this data is recorded in the blockchain, it becomes immutable, meaning it cannot be edited, changed, hacked, or corrupted. To learn how this is done, you will need to stay tuned for the next part of this series because it is going to be a bit technical. In this video's description, I have included a TEDx video on blockchain, which I found interesting, and you can feel free to check it out. Also, if you've stayed till here, type blockchain in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, and Insanians, keep exploring, take care, meet you soon.